Hello, my friends! In this video, I'm going to show you a brief summary about our breeding project with Hypsilurus magnus, or angle-headed forest dragons. We received our parental stock of two animals when they were young in 2020, and we were very surprised when the female laid her first fertile clutch at the age of just 1 year, and these two beautiful babies are what we got from the first clutch. This is how they look like. So this is the adult male. The female is right behind me in the terrarium. Currently we have more than 20 babies. Some of them are already sold, some are left for breeding purposes, and in the following video material I will show you different stages of our breeding project, from incubation of eggs to raising of juveniles. Thank you very much. I hope you will enjoy it. Let's go! These lizards inhabit Indonesia and Papua New Guinea. They are diurnal, spending most of the daytime hanging on tree trunks and branches in deep tropical forests. Males can be easily distinguished from females thanks to higher cervical crests that can comparably be seen at the age of about 6 months. Another way of sexing can be applied in the very first days after hatching. If a torch is placed under the baby's cloaca, you will see two dark prolonged regions at the tail base, which are hemipenises of a male, or if you see nothing, you have a female. The information on this method and other info that we successfully used and adapted to our facilities was kindly provided by expert in Hypsilurus magnus and other related species, Ivo Apetauer. We keep them in vertical terrariums of about 100 cm height or more if possible, with frontal, lateral or upper part made of metal net for proper ventilation. The inner decoration of the enclosure includes vertical, horizontal and angled branches, some artificial plants to imitate the atmosphere of green tropical forests, and provide visual barriers between animals and keepers. Water dish and feeding dish are always present inside. Big broad moist chamber with coconut substrate is always inside the terrarium. It is 15-20 cm deep and female can use it for making and hiding her clutches. We use mulch or small bark chips as a substrate. Some big pieces of cork can be added as well. Lighting period is 12-14 hours during breeding season, with decrease to 8 hours in winter, from December to February. We use UVB lighting with simple incandescent lamp to provide a basking spot. Ambient temperature should be around +25, +28 degrees Celsius at day and not lower than +24 degrees Celsius at night. At basking spot, the temperature is about +35 degrees Celsius. During breeding season, we spray the enclosure lightly 3-4 times per day. Every night we turn on the fogger system at evening for 10 hours to provide an effect of wet tropical forest. During light winter dormancy, the fogger is turned on for only 2 to 3 hours in the evening, and the number of spraying sessions is reduced to only 1 session per day. Water dish is always inside the terrarium and we change the water regularly. Their diet consists of various insects, crickets, locusts, cockroaches of appropriate size. Along with insects, we always offer finely chopped salad mix consisting of Chinese cabbage, salad, arugula, basil, carrots, sweet pepper, dandelions, etc. Of course, salad and insects are dusted with calcium powder. Despite the information available on the internet that many species close to Hypsilurus magnus are ready to breed at the age of 3 years, our female made the first clutch at the age of about 1 year. Duration of gestation is 20-25 days. Female lay a clutch of 2 oval eggs, but not at once. The gap between 2 eggs is usually 1 week. Eggs are buried into the moist chamber or laid in the substrate. Our pair so far laid 22 eggs, so approximately 11 clutches. Eggs are incubated with the obligatory presence of night temperature drop. During the daytime, the eggs are inside the incubator at the temperature of about +28 degrees Celsius. and at night they are left inside the laboratory with a temperature of about plus 25, plus 26 degrees Celsius. Humidity for incubation is 70-80%. Incubation substrate is a mix of perlite and vermiculite. During incubation, eggs demonstrate considerable growth. Average incubation time is 76 days. After hatching, babies can be kept individually or in pairs. Horizontal terrarium of 120 by 50 by 50 centimeters works well for two babies. Interior decoration includes paper instead of substrate, which helps to monitor feces and consumption of food. Branches, feeding and water dishes are always present inside the terrarium. Тихо.
Классно.
Окей. Well, I hope that you enjoyed the video and it was really interesting for you. Anyway, we consider this species to be very promising in herpetoculture and we think that this species should be spread among reptiles collections all over the world. I hope that you enjoyed the time that you spent with us and now subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Facebook and stay safe.